friends, welcome you all to my YouTube channel. And in this video today we are going to talk about a very interesting topic, persistent organic pollutants, means POP. So let us know what is persistent organic pollutant or what are persistent organic pollutants. Okay, so let me tell you, persistent organic pollutants जो होते हैं एक ऐसे ऑर्गेनिक केमिकल सबस्टांसेस होते हैं जो कि कार्बन बेस्ड होते हैं और उनमें यानी कि उनका एक ऐसा पर्टिकुलर फिजिकल और केमिकल प्रॉपर्टी इस तरह से होती है कि अगर वो एक बार एनवायरनमेंट में रिलीज हो जाए यानी कि एनवायरनमेंट में आ जाए मुक्त होते हैं तो ऐसे सबस्टांस काफ़ी सालों तक बिना डिग्रेड हुए यानी नष्ट हुए वो परसिस्टेंटली बहुत दिनों तक रहते हैं. और ये कहीं ना कहीं अगर हम बात करें इनके डिस्पर्सन की या डिस्ट्रीब्यूशन की तो ये वाटर के थ्रू या सॉइल के थ्रू या एयर के थ्रू काफ़ी वाइड एरिया में डिस्ट्रीब्यूट हो सकते हैं. और अगर ये सॉइल में है तो कहीं ना कहीं एक और इश्यू आता है जैसे कि हमारे जो लिविंग ऑर्गेनिज्म जैसे इंक्लूडिंग ह्यूमंस की अगर बात करें या एनिमल्स की तो उनके फैटी टिश्यूज जो है उस पर एक्युमुलेट हो जाता है. और जैसे जैसे जो फूड चेन है फूड चेन में ये नेक्स्ट लेवल पे यानी कि अगर हम बात करें लेवल वन लेवल टू लेवल थ्री तो जैसे जैसे फूड चेन में अगर ये इंटर कर जाए तो ये एक्युमुलेशन इसका जो रेट है वो इंक्रीज होते जाता है और कई प्रकार की फैटलिटीज हो सकती है. तो अब बात करते हैं कि एज ए रिजल्ट ऑफ रिलीज टू द एनवायरनमेंट ओवर द पास्ट सेवरल डिकेड्स ड्यू टू स्पेशली ह्यूमन एक्टिविटीज़ POPs आर नाउ वाइडली डिस्ट्रीब्यूटेड ओवर अ लार्ज रीजन इंक्लूडिंग दोज वेयर परसिस्टेंट ऑर्गेनिक पॉल्यूटेंट्स हैव नेवर बीन यूज्ड एंड इन सम केसेस दे आर फाउंड अराउंड द ग्लोब. So, extensive contamination of environmental media and living organisms include many foodstuffs and has resulted in the sustained exposure of many species, including humans, for periods of time that span generation, resulting both acute and chronic toxic effect. So, friends, I'm now going to talk about that how many POPs have been identified in according to Stockholm Convention. So initially there were 12 POPs but currently 6 new POPs have been added in the list. So we can say that now 28 persistent organic pollutants are currently enlisted in Stockholm Convention. Okay, so what are the initial, let's talk about the initial persistent organic pollutants. So friends, initial persistent organic pollutants under the Stockholm Convention causing adverse effect on human and the ecosystem, and this can be placed in three categories. Pesticides, first one is that pesticide, second one is that industrial chemicals, third one is that byproducts. So in pesticide like aldrin, chlorodane, DDT, dieldrin, indrin, heptachlor, hexachlorobenzene, myrix, toxaphene. In industrial chemical, hexachlorobenzene, polychlorinated biphenyls means PCB, and in byproduct category, hexachlorobenzene, polychlorinated dibenzo, p-dioxin, and polychlorinated dibenzofuran and PCBs. So let us talk about one by one about aldrin. So aldrin, it is a pesticide applied to soil to kill termites, grasshopper, corn root thorn and other insect pests. And aldrin can also kill bird, fish and humans in one incident. Aldrin related rice is believed to have killed hundreds of shorebirds, waterfowl and passerines along the Texas Gulf Coast when these birds either ate animals that had eaten the rice or ate the rice themselves. In humans, the fatal dose for an adult male is estimated to be about 5 gram. Human are mostly exposed to aldrin through dairy products and animal meat. So studies in India indicate that average daily intake of aldrin and its byproduct dialdrin is about 90 microgram per person. That is very serious issue. Now second one is that chlordane, that is listed under annex A, used extensively to control termites as a broad spectrum insecticide on the a range of agricultural crops. Chlordane remains in soil for a longer time and has a reported half-life of 1 year. So friends, about these POPs we shall talk in detail in the next video lecture, but for now let me tell you about the 12 POPs. So this was the chlordane second one, and third one is DDT, and fourth one is dialdrin, fifth one is indirin, sixth one is heptachlor, seventh one is hexachlorobenzene, eighth one is myrex, ninth is toxaphene, 10th is polychlorinated biphenyls, 11th one is polychlorinated dibenzopyridoxime, and 12th is polychlorinated dibenzofuran. So these were the 12 persistent organic pollutants. But friends, what are new 16 POPs that have been added in the list? So let us talk. New POPs under the Stockholm Convention are alpha hexa chlorocyclohexane, beta hexa chlorocyclohexane, chlordecone, dexabromodiphenyl ether, dicofol, hexabromobiphenyl, hexabromocyclododecane, hexabromodiphenyl ether, and heptabromodiphenyl ether, hexachlorobutadiene, lindane, pentachlorobenzene, pentachlorophenol and its salt and esters, perfluorooctane sulfonic acids, its salt and perfluorooctane sulfonyl fluorides, perfluorooctanoic acids and its salt and PFOA related compounds, polychlorinated naphthalenes, short chain chlorinated paraffins, technical indosulfan and its related isomers, tetrabromodiphenyl ether and pentabromodiphenyl ether. So these were the 16 new POPs which have been enlisted in the current list. But friends, let me remind you that these 16 POPs have been added in the year 2017. So thanks for watching this video. I will meet you all in the next video with a new topic. Till then, enjoy your day, keep studying, have a nice day, bye-bye.